Welcome everyone to another video. Guess we are live. Always need to wait longer, actually, how many drop frames, because yesterday I noticed if I start speaking instantly we get some crop video. I also continued with something I wanted to do for quite a while already here on the P3, which is a very curious Linux frame buffer setup. Most likely, I mentioned this before already, because two reasons that Sony did not a decade ago, 15 years ago, when they had actually official Linux support, right? This is how all of this other OS started. They thought it's a super clever idea not to give Linux direct access to the RXX because near security, you could also do security, right? But anyway, and so due to that, the Linux frame buffer is a little bit curious because no direct graphic acceleration. And the other thing has to do with this memory bandwidth. So we have on the cell PowerPC core, we have their XDR memory, and on the RSX, on the NVIDIA GPU, we have GDDR3 memory, of course, both with different bandwidths. And then with all the FlexIO bus stuff and so on, system bus, we also have vastly different read and write speeds. So the cell can read here to the direct connected XDR memory with a whopping nearly 17 to 25 gigabit read and write. And the RSX specifically, there on the RSX side, also some 16-ish to 10 gigabyte per second. But if you cross these domains there on this FlexIO bus, if the cell needs from the cell to the RSX read and write, then we get not as amazing speeds. Here, writing is quite okay, 4 gigabyte. Well, not amazing, but still pretty okayish. But reading is super, super slow, like really slow, like 386-ish, slow, 16 megabyte per second. From the cell PowerPC core, reading from the RSX attached GDDR3 memory. And for the RSX, it is similar, however, not as bad, actually. Fun fact, that is actually with DMA stuff here, faster than local attached. Or is it even, what do I even saying? Oh, no, it isn't. I mixed this. Anyway, doesn't matter. So due to that memory imbalance here of speeds, somehow the upstream kernel developer thought it's a good idea to have this VRAM in system memory. So all the other OS, I've mentioned this already previously, all the other OS official Linux stuff always have stolen here in P3 setup the precious system memory. And today I finally got away, well, started to get away with it. And so it's here in setup C, because the problem is in Linux or many other operating systems, you can't even allocate such a large amount of continuous memory due to memory fragmentation. So after the kernel is booted, it's actually pretty hard to get some 8 or whatever megabyte continuous memory. This is why they do this here in P3 setup, very early routines here on the system startup. And they basically steal here, what was the name, frame buffer or video memory of something. And the default configuration here is a whopping 9 megabytes. So unless you change this, this config frame buffer P3 default size multiplied by 1024 by basically 1 megabyte. So unless you change this, and probably you will not change this, you're wasting 9 megabyte of, well, wasting you for having video output, you're spending 9 megabyte, which is of course crazy, right? So I mean, not only does the P3 not have the most memory with 256 megabyte on the CPU and 256 megabyte on the GPU. Well, if you have the retail anyway, this has, the debug tool has a little bit more. So 9 megabyte, which I calculated this previously, so you're basically spending 9 out of 250 something, a little bit stolen by the hypervisor and stuff. So whopping over 3% you are wasting there. And this bothered me already for always, but certainly after we did this RSX stuff greater again, it bothered me even more, especially as we are getting a little bit more RSX acceleration working. And I thought, hey, isn't it nice certainly even for me with 512 megabyte memory, but even more so for you playing along at home if you're not wasting 9 megabyte of precious system memory, basically for free. And so I wanted to change this here. So how this works is in the frame buffer for this really exotic setup, which very few frame buffers probably do, in the Linux setup, we allocate this memory and then we use this here for the video memory. What was even the video memory of something? Although now this is not the best because I modified this already. But probably can still show this somewhat. I already modified this here of also various probe. And so because we attach this memory to the frame buffer console of this fancy console stuff here on the PS3. Obviously, so all the frame buffer Xorg, like unaccelerated Xorg stuff of previous times and frame buffer stuff here of all the stuff, right, is writing to system memory. And we eventually, of course, when you just write it to system memory, it's not appearing on your video output. So we need something, the original developers needed something to get this video memory output there on the HDMI connector. And the way they do this here is extremely wasteful, somewhat wasteful anyway. They have here a kernel thread, so basically a sub-process, a program, a K-thread run here, this PS3 frame buffer D, which will we also delete next. And what this is doing is that each time, each vertical retrace, so vertical retrace all the previous videos, this is what you also see here scanning out basically on this nice simulation here. So this is anyway. So vertical, so the video memory is output to the VGA or HDMI or DVI video output here, pixel by pixel and all. Eventually, so we, in an old-fashioned CRT terms where you could see this, so we output this picture also on the TV or CRT, and then the cathode ray there needed to return, and this is the vertical retrace. Also in most electronic stuff, you usually can get some kind of interrupt, so that even in DOS games, with a VGA card, you could update your graphics when the whole picture is scanned out to the video output port. And so to get this video from the super highly inefficient, totally insane setup, each vertical retrace we get here from the hypervisor, this kernel thread is waiting for this retrace, vertical retrace, and then blitting outputting. This was original in the Sony otherwise. The only function the hypervisor provided was blit block transfer from the system memory to the NVIDIA RSX. Of course, totally wasteful. I'm surprised it wasn't that much slower. You also see this here. So this would be here, this task thing, also has zero frames, amazing stuff. By the way, I hope the audio is okay. So this is, where is the thread here of PS3FBD here. So this is basically always while not should stop. So it only should stop when we like shut down or unload the module. So basically like infinite loop here for the most time. Then fine, it's interruptible, whatever. And if it's kicked, so this is kicked, is a variable, internal maintenance variable for we should output this. So if it's like kicked, also yeah, professional naming there, it's Sony and upstream kernel, can't even make this up. Personally, yeah, I would choose another name, but we are, anyway, not Linux kernel developers, so I would like to output or whatever, output or whatever, or blit or whatever. But anyway, so if it's bloody kicked there from the Linux kernel developers, then reset this, like clear this, lock the console, and then PS3 three frame buffer sync. This is an internal function, and in other OS days, in 15 years ago in Sony official, when Sony has even written this right here of copyright 2006 Sony Computer Entertainment. So totally wasteful setup of not only wasting 9 megabyte plus minus whatever you configure there, but for full HD you need something like 9 megabyte in system memory, and then 60 times or whatever your vertical refresh frequency is, 16 times scanning out. So only thing that RSX ever did on Linux is copying this DMA direct memory transferring. I'm actually surprised. So today is the first time ever I disabled this. So I changed this here to, I'm still, because testing this, everything of this stuff already consumes way too many hours anyway. Next I will, unfortunately we will most likely not get away with the system buffer entirely, but we will most likely, I hope this works, that we only use 1 megabyte or maybe even less, we will see. But certainly even if we use 1 megabyte, it's still 8 megabyte more memory for you to play along at home. We need this memory because it's also documented here somewhere, like GPU start, and this is since probably not sure if this was forever, but at least it's probably since Sony firmware 2.10, or is it 2.10, or it's running in GameOS, not sure. Anyway, maybe it's because we're running in as GameOS in custom firmware as OS plus, but the issue is that the frame buffer, we need to call the hypervisor and ask the hypervisor nicely, hey, we want to use this GPU stuff, and provided a VRAM address to BitBLT. And so we need there something, so we cannot remove this buffer completely, I think. But we can hopefully decrease the size vastly to only 1 megabyte. Actually, fun fact, we could actually test this here while, let's actually test this here live on YouTube. So again, to summarize this, Sony has done so because if you would not do this, it's actually all this insane setup is mostly a performance optimization for reading from the cell. So if you write a game and you scroll something, or even here this Linux frame buffer, that it would be doc, oh, also wrong keyword, this would be doc slow. Like right now it's already a little bit slower, but I don't care, we don't want to use the frame buffer much anyway. I rather have 8 megabyte for you and me to play along at home, and we want fully isolated Xdriver anyway, so YOLO whatever. And this is still plenty fast. Maybe it's certainly tiny little bit slower because we write with, maybe it's actually not that much slower, but we basically write here with cell write to with 4. So we write this frame buffer data with 4 gigabyte per second instead of 25-ish. But in contrast, in difference, we avoid this bloody inefficient background stuff. So we can, for a test, I had this already commented out. Let's make not too big of an experiment, or should we? Because I've not yet removed our, should we remove? Maybe we make an experiment. Although it's usually not good to test two things at a time. Also, I'm actually compiling a GTK plus on the, this also failed. Why? What have we done now? Don't tell me this. Also, sometimes this Ethernet fails. Yeah, it's probably a little bit slower, unfortunately, but I don't really care at all. We want full acceleration. No, this is not why. Zero drop frames, what happened? No, it's still working, but why is my... Anyway, you probably all agree, most of you, I'm probably the only one who's using the frame buffer and the scrolling speed, YOLO, whatever. I rather, again, want much more. 8 megabyte might be already what you're missing to run some GNOME file browser or something. What is here with... this was just... Sort already the wait a second, this probably is, yeah, we had this already. What was this? This is of course now a little bit wasteful time of I did this the other day. Was this? Anyway, probably, whatever. Bloody eating stuff. Let's fully delete this here for the maximum test. Right now I'm running this not only the VRAM directly mapped and used and assigned to the frame buffer area, and I added here a go to, like this one function returned directly a go to here from for the sync function. It had the go to return immediately for a quick test. So this task, what is this? Shut down. Okay, this task we want to do away with completely. Maybe that's all. And then also, where would that be? Maybe is it in setup? The question is always in the Linux kernel stuff, where are they? Oops, PF3, FB, where would the size? This is this again, default size. Let's make this. One complication is. Yeah, there's so much to testing this fully. We then need to change here also the code for the mode setting. So yeah, basically I need to actually, it's not only this small thing, I actually need to rewrite the half of the frame buffer thing because it's not as easy as just deleting here, deleting there. Not only did you have to wire this up, like with memory mapped I/O, remapping stuff and so on, and test that it actually works, but now we need to change the mode setting. Frame buffer, where would be the size? Frame buffer alloc. We should. So the size is also here somewhere. Video memory size. And that is not our video memory size anymore. There's so much to change this live on YouTube. Because. Command buffer size is 2 MB. This would already fail, not enough. So apparently the command buffer wants to be 2 MB, maybe. That was P3, so then probably 9M. Where was that? Default 2. Maybe we make it. Can we make it 3? Yeah, it was 9, so it can be just for a quick test. And the other thing we need to do is. So this maybe means, not sure who has done this. This maybe means that the hypervisor might actually fail if we say we want 2 MB. So we still save 6 or 7 MB, depending on how much we change later. But video memory size. Is this a mode setting or probe? What do we have here? This is max. Where is this? So this is something. If this is greater this. Where do we have video memory size? This probably need to be a little bit careful, not that we overrun here with this experimental modification. The problem is we need to change this for mode setting. Because otherwise with 3 MB, so it would not allow us a full HD mode. FIFO start, frame buffer start. Yes, yeah, so here's, so this is my modification here already. So maybe we make this here some 16 megabyte just for the testing out of it. And of course we can't use this video memory size here. And basically we can make this also the same 16 megabyte here. Again, later this needs to be more nicely changed. But for a quick test tonight, this probably could do. And somewhere needs to be mode setting, wherever that is. View memory, what is this? LV1, GPU context, IO map. Where is that? In shutdown. Whatever shutdown. Not really concerned about shutdown right now at context handle. Why would this be IO map? Okay, whatever. Okay, init, we just need something here. Where would be the mode setting test for video memory size? Set mode. Does it not check anywhere for the size or what? Okay, whatever. We could also theoretically YOLO this and overwrite this video memory size, because the issue is I could miss here something and then we don't get any boot output, which always is a little bit inconvenient. So yeah, welcome everyone, by the way. So yeah, video memory size. The question is, so this is mapped. We could actually theoretically overwrite this here somewhere. Oh, we don't. How do we do this? Or is SMEM, are they using this for mode setting? Clear screen base. So this is our IO remap from the hypervisor. Yeah, we could test this and hope for the best. What have we? I deleted the fix file. I deleted the kernel thread and we made this 2-3 megabyte. Did I overlook anything? Anyway, this is not even everything we need, so let's quickly test. I hope this. Okay, fix file diff. Let's file diff. This is all we deleted. 2x and then here's some architecture PowerPC 64 package Linux x2 666 9 PS3, FB, no, no threat patch. Let's see how this is going, and then probably eventually with all this testing another day I also need to more rewrite this code, because in the meantime after so many people touching it becomes a little bit horrible. Let's compile this and see what happens. So what do we have in the audience? Cheesecake, you should also remove the call to wake up process in something that might crash and it will not be new. Thank you for that. Wake up. Don't have wake up here. What you saying in vsync interrupt? Vsync interrupt. But thanks for playing along at home. Our wake up process as this task. Did I not delete this task fully? I didn't remove the task structure there. Yeah, so theoretically we could the task if is blanked atomic read. External flip. Wake up interruptible wait vSync. Wait vSync. Wait queue. Wait vSync and is kicked. Wait event. Wait for vSync. We need this for something. Okay, maybe we don't delete that much. Is kicked. Is kicked. We probably don't need. And oh, is it task? Task. Struct task. Do we have is kicked? Wake up process. Basically, we wake up process FB task. But so that is a little bit more deletion there. Fix file diff. Is this proper of all we wanted to delete? Let's see. Yeah, theoretically, I messed this up a little bit. Theoretically, it's best to pre-compile this. It could be that this will error out with some trivial thing. I should have stopped the interrupted this build a little bit at a more useful state, but I mostly wanted to have this as what did I hit 669 of thread, overwrite this and clean and recompile. So yeah, as I said, so not only could this fail and simply not compile because overlooked there's something, I should have been a little bit more pre-tested, but now, but actually what was this shared? Did I not shared MIME info? But yeah, this could crash and burn and yeah, could have no output, output crash and burn and everything in between. Certainly not the most cool opt. Post install d of gdk, not really sure which of what fun little stuff did I have this here still. What surprises me a little bit is that I thought it was wasting so much memory, so memory bandwidth. So we are wasting basically with this really stupid threaded setup of copying, blitting the stuff. Of course, it's a little bit PowerPC of precious PowerPC cycles here that we waste a little bit, but we waste enormous amounts of memory bandwidth, right? This is in full HD 1920 by 19 by 16 by 10 200 I think multiplied by 4 bytes, so 9 megabyte, and this was 60 frames, so this is a whopping 550 or so megabyte memory bandwidth of DMAing this boring the NVIDIA RSX. Whole lot of bandwidth wasted, and I actually tested this compiling because I'm currently compiling as a media player. I wanted to watch some movie, obviously, on the P3, and I compiled here ATK twice. So this compile time of earlier today or something, but by the way, I think it's a clock wrong. Anyway, so this was 2 minutes, 2 minutes and 10 seconds, and this is rebuilding this. And it's not faster, to my surprise. I would have expected wasting half a gigabyte of memory bandwidth could slow down compilation a little bit, but unfortunately didn't much. So yeah, not that much. Maybe not as much. Maybe you see this, maybe if you really run RSX stuff, offload stuff like real DMA stuff on the FlexIO stuff to SPUs and so on. But just compiling something on the PowerPC core, even with half a gigabyte memory, unfortunately not faster. This is also curious. I had this on. How did I fix this stupid thing? Also, here, amazing complexity of open source desktop stuff in 2020. I actually sort this shared MIME info fix this, but apparently it didn't. That is really strange. Especially as I think this shows PNG, doesn't it? Whatever, probably something for another day. So yeah, we are compiling here on the Ryzen, obviously, because on the P3 this would take a day or week. And Linux, let's see if we are compiling that. Let's less this here. Did we already P3 FB? Patching, more patching, and the most patching, and warning, looks like maybe we compiled this with a handful of good warnings. Yeah, ISOC forbids mixed declaration, sorry, and code, whatever. Unfortunately, this changed, so this proof of concept changed as so often. Not only does it take an hour or two of testing this, coming up with this, reading all the code, understanding all the code, changing the code, and editing, booting, compiling until it actually works, proof of concept. Next, I also need to change this custom IOCTLs. We YOLO'd there some custom IOCTLs for mapping, because previously, of good old-fashioned history fame, we could only access a frame buffer, like the system memory DM8-out frame buffer or system memory. And this custom IOCTLs of other OS fame from a decade ago already, from other people, that I only updated and got to work again. We need to update them again as well, because this is changes. We break our own isolated X drivers, so much too. We just got it working a little bit and we break it again. But best probably to break it now instead of then later. Because it's probably this one, I guess. So this custom IOCTLs we use to map the VRAM and this command FIFO stuff. And yeah, we need to change this again, because now we just change that this VRAM is actually VRAM. Yeah, this frame buffer is not so what was a frame buffer, the system memory, but I guess the idea, complicated, confusing setup anyway. So yeah, zero drop frames, either Vodafone, DOCSIS cable, stuff got their stuff together or whatever. So yeah, welcome everyone. Hope you learned something. Yeah, compiled. Even on the Ryzen, just archiving the set standard takes a little while here, of highly compressed set standard frame. So probably really don't want to compress hundreds of megabytes on the PS3, obviously. Right now we have, by the way, in cases boots, not sure if that will boot. With my luck, maybe it does not boot, but yeah, on your PS3 at home this will be more visible, but yeah, not really sure where we will see this. Actually not really sure where the Linux kernel subtracts us already. This is early allocations there, but yeah, or did not. Anyway, let's copy this and over. Did we really finish? Not really running. I know we are still running, so much to that. But that we copy there some stuff. But yeah, anyway, if you have any questions, let me know. But yeah, this is all the details, not only on the P3, but also modern. You have a similar issue on modern NVIDIA, PCIe, NVIDIA and AMD and Intel stuff, with also shared memory on Intel and AMD and NVIDIA, and all the programming and DMAing there between all the different memory and stuff. So SCP there to the cell. This I shortly need to hide. And Then, yeah, even extracting this right now, we are running uname A562. Let's mine install this 5 point, or did I still? Oh, wait a second. Oh, this was the wrong one anyway. I changed the version number because I actually wanted to build this much to that. Fail. But yeah, this 3 is not released. I just changed this because I wanted actually not to overwrite my kernel. Why is this now? Are we compiling or? Don't tell me now we have live broken the. Looks like we. Yeah, this is also super annoying. Yeah, prepare to Eric's. Yeah, so much too. Thank you for that. Now we need to reboot. Probably I should have. Should have booted with whatever, someone at Cheesecake or so recently. Was it Cheesecake or? Anyway, yeah, this is super annoying. Also, yeah, professional kernel developers. And then your JLX something SKB alloc fails off. Nah, can't mix this stuff up. Exactly the round trip time that is not amazing. But here we are. By the way, one benefit of this actually is that previously, when we write now, we write to the RSX and we usually sooner than later crash it and we get an hypervisor GPU exception and nothing works anymore. With this change, probably the frame buffer should still work because now with this modification, the Linux frame buffer stuff writes the data directly to the NVIDIA RSX memory, and this should still work even for the case that we crash the RSX and it's stalled as in not doing something anymore. Hello, why is this connection reset by peer? No surprise there. This, yeah, so yeah, this would maybe help for debugging a little bit. Have not yet tested this. 5, 6, you can also do that here, live on the cell of root and test of mine. Ah, come on, too many keyboard wipers. It's always, you get used to this stuff and just when you get used to this and another keyboard always a little bit. Yeah, I need to check this, or probably I should actually, I don't know, if this actually fixes this. Have you really in-depth tested that it fixes this, or only hoping for the best? Because, yeah, super, super annoying such bugs. I really wonder. Actually, you know what, we could switch over this. Fun fact, probably I should mention that there is a flag for, oops, for the frame buffer API that controls whether the Linux frame buffer should, the console layer should actually copy this, like bit like memcopy this, scroll this data, or if it should re-render this. And that would be here in, I think I have 666 or something of VRAM here. So I'm also removing this FB info reads fast because with this change, reads are not fast anymore and this should actually trigger. So without this change, it's probably super slow because, yeah, scrolling with 4 MB/s, not amazing. Basically, yeah, you could probably watch this. And with this flag removed, it should actually re-render as in, render as in writing all the pixels, so not copying this with memcopy, but re-splitting all this individual text stuff. So yeah, then we probably can reboot and see how this is going. Keep your fingers crossed. Questions on the audience. Is this keyboard mechanical? It looks. Oh, don't your fingers feel the pain? If what don't your fingers feel the pain if it's not mechanical? Well, I have two keyboards here. But thanks for asking. So the Sun keyboard is a membrane keyboard. It's not the most amazing, but at least it has here 10 extra keys that I use for frame buffer. And this here, Techioda DIY, soldered this previous video, Techioda 2 with TrackPoint. This is using Cherry MX. You could also put other keys in there, but I put there, hey, we have there something. And I saw there already something that is not good, but at least we have still boot output. So let's scroll up there. I soldered into this because I had other, I had there, what do I have? I have there Cherry MX White or something in some vintage old, and I have MX Brown in some other small keyboard. And I wanted to test red, so this is a silenced red from this DIY soldering build. And yeah, relatively okay. So let's check. That should be uname A. This should be from, yeah, the the Ryzen date somehow. What is here? Some date is here out of sync. So this is actually UTC. This is time zone, not time zoning, but whatever. I saw there's something. Let's see, what do we have here? So it looks like it still works. We get, however, some graphic exception. Oh, what is it? VSync. We get a graphic. Curious. But you see, this is actually not really what I wanted to test. Not really sure why we got this. What? Because we shouldn't really blitz this here, should we? Whatever. But how much memory do we have free now? So 400 is, it probably is more, right? I think we had less, did we not hit 470? And we shouldn't have this. We can also check with PSAX. So yeah, a proof of concept. Maybe this is still calling some sync of whatever, which obviously we don't need this bloody sync anymore. It's by the way, using this sync for zeroing the memory, maybe that's where this is graphic at, but what, it's not what I wanted. So there you see, you delete some code, people in the audience tell you already like, hey, look, you overlooked a call to wake up process. So thanks to that, even with 100 eyes in the audience, you still have some unexpected graphic exception. But actually it's more that I, with my luck here, usually I expected it not to work at all. But yeah, but thankfully we have tested the theory already. So there you see the hypervisor stopped the RSX. So this ring buffer thing is, should be dead. I have not yet found. So if this, my problem is also, which by the way, I soon, by the way, stopped. So all improvements, I made it already great again, or greater than it ever was, and saved us some 6 to 7 megabyte or whatever. So it's also up to you playing along at home. Send me patches, because I will not do all the 3D work myself here. I have also other stuff to do. But what we eventually need to figure out, how we can restart this. I tried already a couple of theories. I tried to reset this get and put pointer, and that didn't help. I tried to call some hypervisor function, that didn't help. Maybe we, yeah, anyway, we need to research this. So if you want to disassemble the hypervisor, or if you have any inside knowledge, by the way, in any case, if you have inside knowledge with Spark, SGI Octane stuff, SpeedRacer, Ingress, vPro, Odyssey, and all the other fun stuff in between, Secrets or Transmeter. Hey, by the way, this Transmeter sync client there. If you worked at Transmeter and have some insight in code morphing stuff, I have some fun ideas to do. So inside knowledge, my inbox is always ready. If you have some secrets to share, secrets are very good stored on my side. Anyway, so yeah, this is tested, need to clean this up a little bit. And what is also tested is that, as you see, we still run this. So previously that was, well, we cannot start X now, because with our accelerated X would not accelerate, because this command FIFO is not moving now with this graphic exception. But at least we have frame buffer, right? So with debugging, at least, like, hey, at least you have something better than nothing. So this is, yeah, theory fully proven. This is, yeah, fast. This, again, the scrolling might be slightly slower than before, but hey, it's fast enough, especially with this, not with this bit flag of not fast, so that it's not mem copying, but re-blitting this. Save some memory, save some memory bandwidth, and save some kernel thread. Probably, in my opinion, everything pretty amazing, if you ask me. Maybe another day, what we also disabled now is this VRAM previous, this VRAM swap module that in previous decade old, at least when we couldn't use the RSX and we could at least use the 256 megabyte as super fast swap. This module right now doesn't work because we use RSX acceleration, so you can't use this VRAM as fast swap because we are using it for the X server. But theoretically, maybe we could restore something. So if you wanted to, a little bit of, like, say, 100 megabyte of fast swap, theoretically, we could change this other module of reserving something like 128 or something and implement there some cooperative blitting so that at least you can use some. But it's not my highest priority, but just throwing out some ideas of all the stuff that you could do. So we can't start X now because not only have we a graphic exception as theme there, but also I need to adapt this IOCTLs another day that this works again with this changed frame buffer VRAM layout stuff. But yeah, just to document this, how much time this takes, how much thinking of optimizing of what can you do, how this works, of researching all the RSX stuff, and actually not only babbling of uncontrolled rambling about this, but actually getting the code done, and not only, hey, we could do it in theory, but actually doing it in kind of production ready code of something. We should have now no let's grab for PS3 FB, so we shouldn't have any PS3, and we don't have, so no PS3 FBD running anymore. And I unlocked my achievement of today. I hope you learned something of not only of probably the most esoteric frame buffer setup ever. I'm not sure if any other we actually could grab this, right? Of what exotic frame buffer stuff you could implement. We could quickly grab if any other, do we still have, I cleaned this up. Okay, let's build this again. We anyway need to remove this. We quickly grab here if any other frame buffer is using a kernel thread, just for our education. And so that is in driver video fbdev, and let's grab here for kthread. Was it kthread? Yeah, so this was PS3 FB, obviously, before we patched it away. Obviously, did we, hello, patch it away? Smart thread. Oh, wait a second, here's some PXA. So apparently also recursive. So what? Anyway, looks like the PS3 frame buffer and PXA of, was this IPEC or what is it? Some PDA of Intel PXA something. What do they use the K-thread for? Let's see, smart thread of smart update complete smart init of, yeah, whatever, maybe something similar. Oops, did I press a button? Smart update, what do they do with it? Whatever, not really interesting. Anyway, maybe only two frame buffers use some esoteric exotic threading thing. But yeah, I hope you learned something. Some people already ask, yeah, fun stuff. Some people ask in the comments, do you need, how do you learn this stuff? Do you need a computer science degree? And someone answered, yes. I beg to disagree a little bit. In my opinion, many degrees, total waste of money, total waste of time and money. For me, university was super boring because I, with a neighbor, started all the stuff in when we were like 12 and 14 and stuff. And for me, university was mostly waste of time. Everything in university was super boring. And basically, don't wait for university. Just try it at home. Disassemble stuff that you want to disassemble. And don't complain if it doesn't get it back together. But disassemble stuff. Take a look inside. Read books on the internet and Linux kernel sources and other BSD and whatnot, and reverse engineer and disassemble and all the fun stuff. I hope you learned something. Yeah, watch my... certainly, oh, darn, I clicked here again on recording. Darn it, probably that caused some suboptimal encoding output so much too. Clicking here randomly around. Trying to achieve is a P3. Don't watch your channel a lot. You should watch this channel a lot. I just have fun with the P3. I had one anyway, and just showing NVIDIA and Sony the finger of, yeah, so much to taking other OS away from my cold fingers. Anyway, yeah, just having some fun and making the most use of the hardware, because why not? People are interested and waiting for it, so yeah, why not? And you playing along at home and learning something, how to write a driver and stuff. By the way, fun fact, we can theoretically also need to go home, but we can one last thing, maybe fix file and remove here this sync, because I remember in the probe function was some sync stuff left, but this will anyway not be all. So here is some, somewhere was some clearing memory. No, what is a blit fb blit of sync image? What do we have here? P3 sync. Here is clear, so probably this is failing, which certainly we don't need anymore. And I'm slightly wondering if we can get away with 2 megabyte if we. Basically, XDR mem set for screen base. So this is actually DDR, and this XDR we don't really, because we changed. So this is why this is out of sync here. That probably could work. So this is our latest update. Let's try, oops, fix file diff. Let's try if we no thread, if we can YOLO that into here. Probe of line like here. No, it's not here. Is it 957? Or is it also after deletion? Darn it. Now we can append it though here to that. It's not the super nicest. And violet it, let's try with 2 megabyte and let's free. This is probably the most minimal we probably could get away with, I guess. Let's compile this once more. Thread ripping epic AMD Ryzen here should rip through this in just a couple of, I don't even know what is the build time. Let's check actually. Also, fun fact, in the meantime, I rebuilt this quite many times. Just in case you're wondering, of course, with this T2 cross-compile setup, nicely documented. So, not that often. Wait a second, is it even the right one packages? Wise. Okay, I probably deinstalled this, so this is why this is actually deleted. Yeah, so thread ripping through this here in 5 minutes, apparently. Let's see how that is going. But as usual, leave me in the comments below what you think, what you would like to see and not see. Probably next is more FPGA, RISC-V microkernel, because I can't do the P3 stuff each and every day. But basically, leave me in the comments below what you think about this, if you have a P3 or not, or what you want to see, or what would make the most sense. Probably sometime soon we could also start playing some games, but next probably next some FPGA fun. Also MIDI on some FPGA with some MT32, and also other fun stuff here. So the P3 Saga will soon be a little bit less prominent here because also other stuff to do. So yeah, welcome. What is it? How to even pronounce this? Willy or Linux is doing relatively well here, saving some memory, making some progress. Wonder if you could write an OS for the P3 that could be accessed through the XMB menu. Only probably the problem is you can't get the XMB away, so it would be running like a homebrew game without full access, so you could only do what a game could do. If you want, of course there are homebrew examples, certainly you can do that. But it would not be a full OS, as in a full OS with full access to anything. It would be more like a program in Linux, so like a QEMU emulator thing in Linux. Of course, you could do this. There is this homebrew community stuff and lots of support libraries. But yeah, let me also quickly grab a lemonade. I probably could have visualized this here better as in that while I grab something to drink. But yeah, to test this, like for example the comment there with 2 MB, I hope this is accurate, but if this is a command FIFO, command buffer FIFO ring, which even I think even the S3 Verge of previous video fame, of good old fashioned retro vintage programming, I think even the S3 Verge could already do bus master transfer of the command FIFO from system memory. But this is also what we are here for all the education and fun and stuff. But yeah, this is how you test the step by step. By the way, pro tip anyway, always one step at a time. If you do 100 things and you usually break 99 things, so one step at a time, then at least you still have an overview of what is working and whatnot. Eagle Wolf writes, we want SPE acceleration. Well, it depends what you probably don't want. Graphic acceleration versus SPE, that was already done 15 years ago and it was only medium amazing. Of course, the RSX is already there, so do as much graphic stuff with the RSX as you can do and use the SPEs with for other stuff like additional audio decompression, particle systems, texture generation or geometry generation, tessellation and all the other fun stuff. Can we run 64 something ELF on you? What do you mean with 64? What is 64B ELF on? What is 64B ELF? I have no idea. You need to always be a little bit more. 64B, what is it? Except a paragraph and something. Or do you mean 64-bit, I have no idea, you need to tell me what you mean. Always, also fun stuff, always be more verbose and not, because otherwise you comment something that I have no idea what you actually mean. But as usual, you only want to test something. Of course, I prepared here already an hour or two before the video, and then how long does all this stuff take? An hour or two of testing, proof of concept, trial and error, and then talking about this, and then easily also probably already a 1 hour live stream, in case you were wondering. The RSX is good enough for hardware acceleration. Well, yeah, good enough, and of course the RSX, NVIDIA RSX is like a GeForce made for graphic acceleration. Of course, the SPEs are good for additional stuff. Certainly, that is also how the last and latest and greatest PS3 games are so amazing, making the most use out of the RSX and making the most use additionally for geometry, world generation, tessellation and all kinds of other fun stuff, maybe even AI logic. When it's possible to simulate black hole using 24 P3 cluster and the test. Core Program Cluster Program something. Yeah, be my guest and try that out. Let's do here one more boot and see if hopefully we don't get this graphic exception anymore, which also here theoretically we should find out how we recover from that. As fun stuff is because when we reboot it recovers, so I guess some combination. I'm not sure if rebooting, probably I should check how the rebooting works exactly, but we theoretically maybe I should check if kexec execution, another kexecing another Linux kernel, restores the graphics. So that would mean like unregistering the deinitializing the GPU hypervisor LV1 hypervisor calls and reinitializing this in a new Linux kernel resources. So there should be some kind of hope to restore this somehow after graphic exception. It's just a matter of trial and error and time investing. So yeah, set standard compression, even on a... Why is this, by the way, so freaking... Okay, now we... So, SCP this to the cell 562. I hope that is now. Let's shortly hide that. And then let's mine install this here again. And yeah, next again then to restore the RSX acceleration. This other IOCTLs need to think also about. Anyway, even the whole RSX acceleration, theoretically we probably have all the stuff needed for 3D, just time and money, and it probably takes a whole month of sitting here all day of trial and error, getting all the DMA stuff and notifiers working again. And yeah, this is also not only for the P3. The P3 is of course a special case of Sony and Nvidia not wanting this specification, but in general, if we would have an like the G5, where we also have an Nvidia GeForce or any other stuff, like a modern Nvidia for all the Linus Tech Tip fans of Nvidia fan goodness, you cannot just write your own kernel, right? If we write our microkernel not unrelated of the P3, like say we buy a professional Nvidia GPU and program our microkernel, because microkernel, this is why I call out Nvidia unrelated of the P3, because if I buy with my hard-earned cash an Nvidia GPU, I certainly want to program it however I feel fit and not like Nvidia showing me the finger and not giving me any specification. And this is of course super error prone. If I write my own microkernel, I don't want to reverse engineer Nvidia's Windows driver or other fun stuff. So no, probably we fix this exception with not blitting the stuff that didn't blit anymore. By the way, this looks a little bit off though. This is now a little bit off by something for some reason. I think it was not off before. Is this a new bug? Somehow this is slightly shifted. Fun stuff. This might be shifted by how much? Slightly wonder. I think it was okay. Wasn't it okay a second ago? That is curious. But at least we have no graphic exception, I guess. The shifting could be maybe the hypervisor is doing some nonsense in terms of if we map only with 2 megabyte, because the where are we, because there is some, but we write directly to the frame buffer. I think the hypervisor is doing something really strange now. it's what maybe there's some special case in the hypervisor, because it maybe the Sony people, the engineers of the hypervisor stuff, knew obviously that they need 2 megabytes for the command buffer. Because I don't think I broke the other code, and I thought it was working before. The pity is that we now need to recompile the whole stuff. I wonder, so the problem is, I would wish we could use 2.5 here, but okay, let's use 3. Fortunately, we need to recompile this everything, which takes 5 minutes. And theoretically, I would want to go finally home now. Everybody asks, does AMD provide all technical information to build drivers from scratch? Well, sort of. Mostly, nearly everything what is a little bit missing is mode settings. So maybe due to MacroVision and, well, previous times MacroVision, now what is it? Now it's an HDMI, what is it? Copy, HDCP, H definition, copyright protection stuff. There's some people call this out that, yeah, the Linux driver is using this Atom BIOS table structures to do like scripted like mode setting of, yeah, some people call this not 100% open, which otherwise is certainly better than nothing, but obviously not 100% super perfect. But yeah, that is a little bit, that is, unfortunately, this means that if you want to write your own driver and microkernel stuff from scratch, you would need to implement Atom BIOS table parsing and Atom BIOS script stuff for that. But yeah. T2 32-bit videos, but 64-bit utils for cell, and wonder if you have 64-bit utils for cell. What kind of utils do you have for cell? Need to rewrite those to run. Well, this ISO images are multi-lib, similar to what we always had on PowerPC and x86. That means that you have at least have you have the libc and the GCC support stuff in 64-bit, but nothing else. So you don't have libx11. So all the userland is 32-bit by default, but you have multi-lib with a 64-bit capable glibc and GCC surrounding support library stuff. Curious what you have written there, though. So theoretically, if but it doesn't really matter too much. 2 or 3 megabyte, it still saves you 6 megabyte, which on a 250-something megabyte retail PS3 is of course already quite some. Probably doesn't really make much sense to tweak this further to try if 2.5 megabyte works. But yeah, the next I need to change the IOCTL stuff. Really curious that it's a little bit shifted, but probably it has done here some mode. By the way, which mode do we use? Let's check if, it is, however, full HD plus, so 1920 by 1200, my preferred mode obviously of that. Really, how much is this? Also wrong keyboard. This is really curious how much this is. Anyway, whatever. But yeah. So unfortunately, each try takes 5 minutes plus. That is, of course, in a microkernel environment where we could only rebuild one driver. Well, you could also keep the source tree around and not always rebuild it fully from scratch, but yeah, it comes from doing it the clean room way. Anyway, yeah, so the IOCTL's next. Welcome, everyone. Can we? We can also actually, we could take in one. I slightly wonder, we do not even use a frame buffer in the Xorg driver. Maybe actually, you know what, we could, let's try to be lucky and try to run X, not really sure what will happen. Hey, this even works, lucky us. Can't mix this stuff up. Only live on this channel. So this works accidentally because it is still using, it's not using the, hopefully it should, anyway, it should probably, they also see how waste, yeah, previously we wasted 6-7 megabyte of, if that, yeah. This is right now mostly not accelerated though, but it's using all our other, so the hardware cursor works, for example. This is also faster, by the way, so because this is some not, so there you see this window is not 32-bit and this is 32-bit window, so this, at least this works much snappier. But yeah, we had more acceleration. It's usable, but we need to make it even more amazing, certainly restore all the fancy stuff, but at least it's our full RGB mouse cursor of that sort. And let's see, did we, anyway, it doesn't really matter much, but yeah, this is actually, okay, we are lucky, I don't even need to adapt the IOCTLs because Xorg driver re-ignored the system memory, pseudo VRAM anyway, we only IOCTL mapped our, but this means we could actually simplify, actually, you know what, I think I leave it like this for now. If we leave it like this, for now, we have a tiny little bit more backward compatibility for older kernels of yesteryear, should you, or for research purposes, someone still run this somewhere at home. So yeah, then actually we are lucky and I don't touch that for the moment. But yeah, set standard compression can't mix this up. So what else do we have there? Some more comments. How you begin deal with kernel? Can you tell a little how you begin to deal with kernel space stuff? Well, read the source and cross-match the source until you understand most of it, and then try little steps, like, as I said, not 100 things at once, but just like maybe try to fix a small tiny bug. If like something on a P3 or some vintage gear or something, or a tiny LED driver or like something simple, and start from there and cross-match this with other code and other patches, or like look on kernel changes and like on the, actually fun fact, earlier today there wasn't a new kernel, but can actually check if there is with our luck. Oh no, there isn't, but otherwise, yeah, look just on kernel changes and see what they're changing and understand what they're changing and this is what I just said, but this is cross-compat setup. I could leave it there, but it's a little bit, if I would do this the whole day, I would have left it there, as it is just from having this T2 automatics. But this is what I meant. I earlier actually said you could leave the source tree there and just compile one thing, but anyway, microkernel stuff would still be always much more amazing because you always had this setup. No matter if you have a source tree, you could always have some user space driver. So let's make one more test. That should be this one. And let's see if this is, the shift is actually, wait. Okay, with the Xorg driver, we didn't see a print. This is super difficult to debug. I mostly debug it with good tracing outputs, like good old printf style debugging, comparing what is going on. Also best with secure shell and having graphic output on another machine, because if it locks up and you can't do anything, then at least you have your graphic output, and then log files, comparing all the tracing of what kind of dimensions and registers were used. This in simulation, which in most Linux kernel stuff is not done, but a simulation module. Fun fact, I heard SGI had this, so all the Imgrath and Odyssey see this earlier? How did this happen now? This is really bizarre. I mean, it could be as little as... This is really... I didn't really notice this earlier, though. Some kind of offset somewhere. Only wonder where that is coming from, or is this... Ah, you know what? Do we still add FB start? Is this shifted by... Oh no, this would be shifted more, wouldn't it? Do we still add FB starts there? IO remap VRAM LPAR and screen base FB start and physical address of FB start. That looks correct though. Strange thing that is basically a full one character exactly for some bizarre reason. To even show this, probably not the most fun little bugs. Yeah, so much probably can tomorrow the whole day rinse and repeat here this stuff. Carlos, right, what think about making Linux distribution from zero to learn? Not that much. You don't learn that much. It's just you also it's only very high level packaging of not seeing much and just configure make install, mostly boring thing, can't recommend this. Some people, but if you, as always, if you watch this later and disagree, leave me in the comments below. But yeah, I would probably say it's mostly waste of time, and not only are there 1011 distributions out there, but it's not that much to learn from packaging open source stuff. You don't even look into the source, you just configure make install and rinse and repeat until you have everything together with a working system. So but yeah, probably if you want to do reprogramming, then look at the actual source, not just configure make install. Okay, just wanted to reboot. See, okay, the cursor is blinking here. So that means the cursor should be this. How should this be? This is really curious. I think I would have noticed that earlier when basically when we, which did 669 of this deletion stuff. What do we do here? Do we do some, it's only mem setting here, screen base. Wait a second, why does it... Oh, this was just this. A little bit puzzled how I'm pretty sure we didn't have this before. But this are... I mean, I changed here this, but I don't really think we had here previously. I hard coded this, but basically, this is the last thing, but I don't really see how this. Could have caused this is just memset, which we still have anyway. Why do we even change that? Lines probably should be local variable, shouldn't it? Z somewhat bizarre, to be honest. Maybe we manage this bizarre bug, which obviously is also not the most visible, but I hope you get the idea, don't you? E-display, okay, fine, whatever. But yeah, so I mean the scanout is with the mouse cursor. The mouse cursor is a hardware overlay now. The mouse cursor is correct there. But here we have... Oh, wait a second. What? We have here 11, 8. Yeah, this is 8 pixels. How did we manage that? I think there might even be another graphic artifact or... I think there is some strange graphic artifact also. Hmm. I should have looked. Probably I need to rewrite my own video. So yeah, the usual do one step at a time, because now we did a couple of steps and don't even know how we introduced this fun little bug here. Anyway, that's it for today. I hope you learned something, especially as software development is difficult, especially if you don't have the specification and work here against some somewhat hidden target. Welcome everyone. Thanks for the good work. Optimized for and make a distro optimized for hardware in some tasks. Well, you cannot, if you, I mean, the fun thing is we have some people, I mean, we could delete this here. So what, I mean, we could try, I mean, it should actually not be this here. I mean, it, maybe it means the only thing that as a default, we could actually, you know what, we could probably without recompiling, what was the syntax for that? Do we still have, let's reboot here. Less packages, but deal with the sources. So with just less packages, stuff doesn't become faster and optimize for a hardware, but some tasks. There is not really that much to optimize in my opinion, but correct me if I'm wrong. It's not like you leave some packages out or something and something is more optimized or faster. If you want to get into developing, then actually better look at the sources and read books, as mentioned. at 1000, let's see, you can set this. What was the parameter for this early parse? So that would be video size, various early parse. Line up, mem parse. Name P3. Frame buffer size. Darn, somehow this is somewhat on P3FB early parse. Not very nicely documented. Maybe in driver video FBDiff, maybe in the kconfig. P3FB equals, okay, P3 equals 9MB. Let's see if that fixes that. Args P3FB equals 9M. Was it 9M or? P3FB, let's see, without recompiling, that would be a little bit faster. Off, let's see what happens. Ah, boot game was done. This is such a stupid menu. This always happens. I press B for bootleg and grub, and then it boots this bloody game OS. I really hate this bloody shit. Yeah, system was turn off. No, I think it was like this. Always. Stupid shit. Why did I not lock this? This is not. It was locked. Anyway, whatever. Oh, I think it was this darn stupid menu shit. I'm still using what I needed to use on this tool. There is not really much custom firmware for the tool. I'm using the only things that I have for that. And I prefer not to mess with it because I have other stuff to actually get working, as you see. Yeah, welcome everyone, J-American and everyone else. Yeah, the usual thing of the stream is long enough and I wanted to finish and then we have so many people in the audience. Let's see if this magically fixes this. What the heck have we done now? That is even worse, whatever we have done now. Only live on this channel. Yeah, fun stuff. We want to go home and we have the most people tuning in. I'm not really sure how we should reboot though. Did we not? We do. Anyway, a little bit more guru meditation needed. Or does it want, probably doesn't want to have it like that, does it? What did I hit there before? It's so easy to make a typo here with this stuff. P3FB9M, I think this was what was written there, wasn't it? P3FB9M. This somehow. Very interesting effect. I'm not quite sure. Maybe this early pausing stuff is also broken. It doesn't work for quite some while already. J-American found an old PowerBook. You can certainly test PT2 on this if you want. The question is this new world or old world? This is different kind of open firmware generations. Whether it will work then or not. For example, I've never tested, but probably it is new world already. It's not very helpful, I have to say this testing there. Maybe we... Well, it shouldn't be, I'm pretty sure we would have noticed. I mean, the only thing could be like this thing, but did I not boot or does this? Did we not even test with... typical case for... Need to test my own video. Do we still have this in? Still have this in there. Or is the hypervisor, but we... I think we had... Also, so much to bugs in the hypervisor, potentially. I'm pretty sure we had a correct video output earlier. But yeah, probably if we do this any more often, by the way, fun fact, we do, you know what, we only need to copy the kernel. So maybe we finally make use of not rebuilding this here constantly. Let's see if we configured that. So the way how you would do this, of course, I use T2 for the, by the way, I hope it wasn't tempfs. I use T2 for the cross-compile environment and all the automatic patching. And of course, we don't need to waste the time always with that, rebuilding that, but we can simply build here J32 VM Linux and then only our SCP the kernel over. That certainly saves us quite some time instead of waiting 5 minutes for the compilation and set sound compression and so on. It's general always recommended to certainly create a setup so that not only with Xorg debugging but anything else in between, set it up so that you can work efficiently and lose the least time possible. Wait a second, what are we so broken that... Oh, I rebooted, okay, fine. Then. Because with this round trip time, we can always eval make opt here J32 VM Linux and then SCP just the VM Linux over here of... the only thing is we don't have root login, but there. We need to be... DHCP needs to hello, DHCP. And then... move home VM Linux to boot VM Linux. You could also enable root login, but for testing reasons I don't do here. And that certainly is a much faster edit compile round trip time for just changing this. Of course you can't do this if you change Mons Linux kernel, monolithic kernel, one address space and stuff, then you need to you need to rebuild the kernel if you change more than a little bit, because all the stuff is interlinked and depending on system level definitions there. So this is so this should give us a graphic exception. Let's see if this restores it, because we deleted the code that didn't memset, but I just want to redo a little bit of code to see which change set introduced this strange video offset there. Pretty sure we should have noticed that if we would have had this earlier, though. Yeah, so this is correct. Why is this freaking correct? Or does... Don't tell me we can't save the memory. This would be... So right now this is correct. This should be the state where we have the graphic exception, right? Yeah, here. Of course we have. And then let's try, just for the test, this. Actually, we can now, whatever. Is it 9M or... Okay, right now we defaulted with 4 only. This is funny. So we are running with 4 megabyte and it saves a little bit. Okay, so 4 is... Let's try 3. I mean, 3 didn't work a second ago. Or let's try 2 immediately. I mean, theoretically, we only need 2. Bizarre. .config of ps3fb ps3 of hello. What did we have? Did we have 4? Here it is. Let's test with 2. Let's eval VM Linux. I mean, ideally, I would want. Oh, wait a second. Did we had some issue with 2? What was it? Does someone remember? I mean, very theoretically, you know what? Okay, let's not. What was the thing with 2 megabyte? I think with 2 megabyte we had some strange thing. Wait a second, let's redo this. I think 2 MB was something strange. Let's try 3. I mean, 3 and 4 would not be able to... I have the feeling, anyway, speculation. It's always, the problem is it's not our code. If the firmware or hypervisor would be our code, we could take a closer look. But unfortunately we can't, so that would be 3 MB. Let's CP that. Also not Pongo, did I not? Nah. What do we have? 6, 2. So, comments in the audience. How are the SPU managed in Linux in PS3? How they always are. I think there's some sysfs and some there's some special SPUFS and then the toolchain that basically IBM did back in the day. I still wonder how this whole PS3 Linux stuff came together. Maybe the development cost was so large that somehow IBM had some word in there and said we want some Linux stuff to test or something. This is so bizarre in my opinion that this existed like official other OS stuff at all ever. Okay, actually maybe not as much. Maybe Sony, this is because actually there was for the PS2 Linux, so this also works with, so what have we messed up there? This is, so it looks like, oops, sorry. It looks like, this patch messes this up. How is it possible? Lines equals, full offset, or is this used somewhere? PS3 max lines. Or is this max lines set parameter? Where is it even? Oh, this was here. I mean, so theoretically, we only don't need. What is this lines? Is this lines used somewhere else, or? I mean, basically, this. Lines is only used here. Or is, you know what, maybe it is not, maybe it is the sync image is somehow needed. Can it be that you need to call this once? That this is setting something up in terms of start of frame buffer frame, that you need to call this once. What is it here for? DDR line length, what is it even? Why is here firmware version 1.9 XDR line length? What the heck is going on here? Let's try to only sync image to only also disable this. So this is if we here I have already go to out and here or wait a second, we also have your display flip. Or maybe it was once display flip. Maybe frame offset. Maybe that is a thing. Huh. I think we found the issue. So yeah, source offset, this stuff we don't need right now. If zero, and that is probably the thing. Frame offset, and then where is it? Sync image was. Where is the full offset versus full offset? Start of full screen DDR frame buffer. That is probably the issue. Then I wonder, can we, yeah, not to make the same mistake again, I think we want to only test that. Also, I'm pretty sure probably that will work. Should we? Patch that in also, maybe we should. Ah, no. You type it in the new. Yeah, so then evil, so that is of course again a much better round trip time than waiting 7 minutes just selectively. But again, this is of course not a replacement for microkernel, just because you can rebuild one file. It's not the same as proper abstraction of driver APIs and ABIs and stuff. But yeah, this is certainly the issue that we run into. Then copy that. Then the question is also, can we get away with copied this, so reboot. Also, I didn't show you that in full detail, but we probably can already work on the next thing that is, well, work and work. It's actually not that much work if we only added the config here of equals, what did we add, 3 or... Yeah, ps3, fb something... Three, four, what do we have right now? 4m. Darn, what was the symbol name of the thing? Let's see what happens here. Here is a slip SPE, SPUFS. Yeah, as I mentioned, the SPUFS is, you need to mount that for that control. And no, this does not work. Surprisingly, can't mix this up. This is hilarious. Did I, oops, as you probably see there, can you maybe somewhat a little bit, but, back to the drawing board, I guess. Zoom. Oh, wait a second. Did we? Oh, maybe we. Oh, we didn't. Didn't call this down. Oh, such a stupid noob. Mistake of. Patch this away. What? What a fail. So much too. Can we do two things in one? And of course, we break it. So we have probably fix files. Sync. So what we actually need to do is we don't need to clear this. So this is now DDR. And this stuff we should not need. And this is not really sync image, but we reuse it for now. But basically, I mean, theoretically, it would certainly be actually better if we just use that here, though. To be honest. But for now, what does it have here? It has context handle frame offset. For now, we can probably reuse that just to not change more than we necessarily want. Also broke it. Yeah, all the stupid warnings of stupid LX stuff of 965. Yeah, there is like that probably, yeah, also theoretically I need to get rid of all these other stupid warnings there of expansion of dev error, whatever stuff. Theoretically I wanted to, famous last words of changing, testing two things at a time, but let's anyway do it. IPS3FB, now where was the stupid assignment? M equals some number. Ah, thank you very much. Ah, here it is. Let's try the 2 megabytes that I ideally would want to do. So eval that again. Eagle Wolf asks, am I shooting for full 3D? Well, actually, initially, I only wanted to take it out of the basement and try to get latest Linux running. And due to the title of making it great again, because not really anyone cared about the last decade, people somehow assumed 3D acceleration. And so initially, I only wanted to get it running again with T2 just for the fun of it, that it now became such a big community waiting for this is a new thing. So as I said in the beginning of this live stream, it should be possible, but I probably do not really want to do this all alone. So if you if you are looking for this because for some reason, then you need to help with that and play along at home here and stuff. Because there's only so much I will do with that and not do all of the stuff alone. But theoretically it is possible, maybe maybe in how many years, I don't know. But this is, by the way, somehow I don't really like it the most anymore, but whatever, I guess. So yeah, theoretically it's possible, maybe we do it eventually, but certainly not. Sometime soon. Hey, and we finally, it's fixed and only 2 megabytes. So yeah, the 2 megabyte is probably the minimum we can go for. And yeah, also we figured that detail out in this fun little live stream. Oops, sorry. Wrong focus fix file diff. What have we done? So we have deleted most of this stuff and that stuff and probably call this X now and VI this here and delete that and read in that. Oops, read in that and 1, 2, 3. Probably that and wait a second. Have I done this in the wrong directory? Darn it. Oh, whatever. Doesn't really matter much. So yeah, not the super most super clean thing here with this accumulation of patches, but proof of concept somewhat good enough. We can also test compile this to see if all the patches apply. And while at it, so for you playing along at home, that means we now should have 483. I'm pretty sure we earlier had 470 something. Can we, yeah, somehow the hypervisor takes there quite a bit. We, so this has 512. Somehow the hypervisor takes quite a bit of that, huh? But anyway, I'm pretty sure we had 400 whatever something previously. Yeah, there are some other buffers that are subtracted from that. Let's feel lucky and try to start our partially isolated X and that still works. Although right now it's not with the most acceleration enabled, but yeah, also not the graphic exception. Yeah, actually, yeah, if we, yeah. Yeah, that is a pretty cool achievement as per usual, one step at a time and documenting here all the fun stuff. Also how each and all of you could have done that playing along at home somehow. After moving everything back and forth, not the most thrilled with my camera alignment anymore, but whatever. So yeah, that's really finally it for today. We achieved something. I theoretically should also test it on a retail where the, how much did we save? No, we previously we had 9, so we saved a whopping 7 megabyte. And last but not least, also this is too small text, but last but not least, 7 megabyte from your 250 something is of course nearly 3%, so 3% memory for you for free playing along at home. That certainly is pretty good for the memory limited stuff there that this is. So more RSX later maybe, but probably don't forget to share, like and subscribe to motivate me and yeah, all this stuff. Yeah, the performance, in my opinion, so as I said, probably the scrolling is slightly slower, but seriously, it's still fast enough. And probably most of you never want to work on the frame buffer. And then for X, it doesn't matter if the more acceleration, and in even in our partial accelerated exit, memory was ignored. And one complication, however, is DMA. That is a little bit near due to the, we will figure. Maybe we later need another megabyte for some DMA bounce buffer, but we will see because of the way the hypervisor assigns the system memory context. But in any case, more control, more also, again, the added benefit of if we crash the RSX with some invalid command FIFO stuff, then at least we should have frame buffer. Yeah, we tested this previously an hour ago with our unintentional GPU exception. Now we should always have frame buffer scrolling and text output, even if we lock up the command FIFO, which certainly is helpful in some ways. And memory bandwidth saved and all the fun stuff. So that's really it for today. I hope you learned something. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, recommend the video to your friends and families, and so on. Don't forget to read the source and learn something. And our patches get a little bit out of hand here. Where is it? Here in SVN. P3 patches accumulate here rather quickly. Probably I have to also unify these packages. Probably it's as much as it is documenting step by step of direct VRAM and no thread and stuff, but probably we unite those a little bit for maybe for now I commit them or something, but something of that sort. And I hope to see you soon for the next videos and live streams to come. ARCH64 is working in T2. It's in upstream. Just check it out and configure and stuff. And I probably have a video running ARCH64 change root on a Samsung DeX here of Linux on DeX on Android fun on. So yeah, test it on a Samsung Galaxy DeX for you playing along at home. But yeah. Certainly patches welcome. If you look into this and do something with it, then let us know and don't forget to send us some patches. And certainly also for the PS3 for some emulator and video packages and fun stuff like that.